Other announcements for the parish. Our celebrant for this evening is Father Gregory. Thank you.
And at this time, let's all stand and join in singing our opening song, Gather Us In.
Here in this place, new life is streaming. Now is the darkness vanished away. See in this space our fears and our dreamings brought here to you in the light of this day. Gather us in, the lost and forsaken. Gather us in, the blind and the lame. Call to us now and we shall awaken. We shall arise at the sound of our name. We are the young, our lives are a mystery. We are the old who yearn for your face. We have been sung throughout all of history, called to be light to the whole human race. Gather us in, the rich and the haughty. Gather us in, the proud and the strong. Give us a heart so meek and so lowly. Give us the courage to enter the song.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
We gather this evening to celebrate the second Sunday in ordinary time. Let us prepare our hearts and minds for this celebration. You were sent to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you, we give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, heavenly King, O God, almighty Father, glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill. Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of alone are the Holy One. You alone are the Lord. You alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen. Amen. Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of God.
Almighty ever-living God, who govern all things, both in heaven and on earth, merciful hear the pleadings of your people and bestow your peace on our times. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. For Zion's sake, I will not be silent. For Jerusalem's sake, I will not be quiet, until her vindication shines forth like the dawn and her victory like a burning torch. Nations shall behold your vindication and all the kings your glory. You shall be called by a new name, pronounced by the mouth of the Lord. You shall be a glorious crown in the hand of the Lord, a royal diadem held by your God. No more shall people call you forsaken or your land desolate, but you shall be called my delight and your land espoused. For the Lord delights in you and makes your land his spouse. As a young man marries a virgin, your builder shall marry you. And as a bridegroom rejoices in his bride, so shall your God rejoice in you. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Proclaim his marvelous deeds to all of the nations. Proclaim his marvelous deeds to all of the nations. Sing to the Lord a new song. Sing to the Lord all you lands. Sing to the Lord, bless his name. Proclaim his marvelous deeds to all of the nations. Announce his salvation day after day. Tell his glory among the nations. Among all people, his wondrous deeds. Proclaim his marvelous deeds to all of the nations. Give to the Lord, you families of nations. Give to the Lord glory and praise. Give to the Lord the glory due his name. Proclaim his marvelous deeds to all of the nations. Worship the Lord in holy attire. Tremble before him all the earth. Say among the nations, the Lord is King. He governs the peoples with equity. Proclaim his marvelous deeds to all of the nations.
A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, there are different kinds of spiritual gifts, but the same Spirit. There are different forms of service, but the same Lord. There are different workings, but the same God who produces all of them in everyone. To each individual, the manifestation of the Spirit is given for some benefit. To one is given through the Spirit the expression of wisdom, to another, the expression of knowledge according to the same Spirit, to another, faith by the same Spirit, to another, gifts of healing by the one Spirit, to another, mighty deeds, to another, prophecy, to another, discernment of spirits, to another, varieties of tongues, to another, interpretation of tongues. But one and the same Spirit produces all of these, distributing them individually to each person as he wishes. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Alleluia, 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 alleluia. God has called us through the gospel to possess the glory of our Lord Jesus Christ. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
There was a wedding at Cana in Galilee, and the mother of Jesus was there. Jesus and his disciples were also invited to the wedding. When the wine ran out, the mother of Jesus said to him, "They have no wine." And Jesus said to her, "Woman, how does your concern affect me? My hour has not yet come." His mother said this to the servers, "Do whatever he tells you." Now there were 6 stone water jars there for Jewish ceremonial washings, each holding 20 to 30 gallons. Jesus told them, "Fill the jars with water." So they filled them to the brim. Then he told them, "Draw some out now and take it to the head waiter." So they took it. And when the head waiter tasted the water that had become wine without knowing where it came from, although the servers who had drawn the water knew, the head waiter called the bridegroom and said to him, "Everyone serves good wine first, and then when people have drunk freely, inferior wine. But you have kept the good wine until now." Jesus did this at the beginning of his signs at Cana in Galilee, and so revealed his glory, and his disciples began to believe in him. The Gospel of the Lord. I am quite sure that all of us have had the experience of being invited to a wedding feast. And at a wedding feast, we expect to have good food, we expect to have wine, we expect to have drinks, and then everybody becomes happy. Normally at the beginning, before the wines and beers are served, the environment is a bit careful. Everybody is careful with what he or she says. And the joy level is not that high. But after wine and beers have been served, the atmosphere becomes different. You hear so much laughter. You hear so much joy and people rejoicing. That means, even though some of us may not take alcohol, alcohol brings joy and gladness when people take it. This is the episode we have in our gospel reading. Mary was invited to a wedding. So Jesus and his disciples. The situation here was that they didn't have enough wine. As a result, you are not going to get many people be happy. They rather will complain. If you know you didn't have money, why invite us and not serve us well? So it means the young couple were going to be faced with an embarrassment. They were going to be disgraced that the very important day of their life wasn't well organized. Our Mother Mary, standing by, and saw their humiliation, saw their difficulty, their embarrassment, whispered to his son, "They have no wine." The response of Jesus looks as if disrespecting his mother. He didn't say mother. He said, "Woman, what does your concern have to affect me?" But Mary knew that her son was not going to let her down, and told the servants, "Do whatever he tells you to do." When the servants were told to fill the jars with water, Jesus said, "Draw it out to the head waiter." And this has been the first ever miracle Jesus performed when he came to this world. That means the first miracle was performed at the intercession, at the pleading of his mother. This is how important our Mother Mary is to help us face life. We all have situations in our lives that creates discomfort, that steals our joy away from us, that make us lack peace, happiness within our souls. I have my fair share of them, and I'm sure we each have, as long as we are human beings. My problems are not like yours, yours may not be like mine, but we each have our problems in life. For some of us, our health concerns takes away our joy and our peace. For some of us, our financial situation takes away our joy and our peace. For some of us, our neighbor is our headache. We are not able to see eye to eye, and we are often at each other's throat. Whatever it is, each of us have situations in our lives that take away our joy that take away our peace. That will be our lack of wine. Whatever takes away our joy, whatever brings us embarrassment, is our lack of wine. We have our Mother Mary. If we approach her and let her know our lack, our need, just as she whispered to the ear of her son and she came to the aid of this young couple, sitting by Jesus on his throne in heaven, she certainly will intercede and Jesus will help us out. Let us have faith in our Mother Mary. Oftentimes, others accuse the Catholic Church as worshiping Mary. It's only God that is worshipped. Mary has been given a privileged position to be the mother of the Son of God, and no one can take that away from her. And with that position, she is able to intercede for us. She is able to come to our aid, whatever our needs are. I believe in one God, Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made, for us men and for our salvation. He came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Let us turn to Jesus, who changed water into wine, and ask for his intercession as we open our hearts in prayer.
For unity among all Christians, may the disciples of Jesus from every denomination seek and focus on the common ground we share. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the healing of our nation, may we see an end to bitterness and division. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who suffer discrimination, may they gain strength and inspiration from the life and message of Martin Luther King. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For married people, may the grace of the sacrament of matrimony strengthen commitment and bring couples closer together. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those struggling with addiction, may the light of Christ lead them to the help they need. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our St. Norbert community, may we wisely discern the gifts among us and offer them generously to build the reign of God. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those among us who are sick in body, mind, or spirit, for those listed in the parish bulletin, and especially for Bill Durham, Kathy Durham Stevens, Connie Pilcher, Penny Walsh Sloan, Rick Earhart, Lucina Aviles, Patricia Hamilton, Anna Perez, Maria Aguilar and family, Michelle Olivier, Cecilia Luna, and Don Seferick. May God comfort them and restore them to health. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who have died, especially Mary Estrada, Eliseo Mesa Jr., Maria de Cambra, Edward de Cambra, Mary Jean O'Donnell, Lucille Pelletier, Bertha Escobedo, Lupe Gallegos, Kenan Vauter, Marco Antonio Dorantes, Maria Garcia Hernandez, Adoracion Lemos Guevara, and Stanley Sabula. May they forever rejoice at the heavenly banquet. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for the repose of the soul of Luis Camargo, for whom this Mass is being offered, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Loving God, we are open to your will. Look with compassion upon your faithful ones. Change our sorrow to joy and grant what we truly need in the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord.
You will bear great fruit.
brethren, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Father Almighty. Grant us, O Lord, we pray, that we may participate worthily in these mysteries. For whenever the memorial of this sacrifice is celebrated, the work of our redemption is accomplished. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For you laid the foundations of the world and have arranged the changing of times and seasons. You formed man in your own image and set humanity over the whole world in all its wonder, to rule in your name over all you have made, and forever praise you in your mighty works through Christ our Lord. And so with all the angels we praise you, as in joyful celebration we acclaim.
Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. And you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to his setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come.
Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray upon the oblation of your church and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you will to reconcile yourself, grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, and with all the saints on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your Pilgrim Church on earth with your servant Francis, our Pope, and Van, our Bishop, the Order of Bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family, whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who are pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may always be free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Amen. Let us show this peace to one another.
Sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Grant us peace.
Behold Jesus, the merciful Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Happy are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
One bread, one body, one Lord of all, one cup of blessing which we bless, and we, though many, throughout we are one body in this one Lord. Gentile or Jew, servant or free, woman or man, one Lord of all, one cup of blessing which we bless, and we, though many, throughout the earth, we are one body. Many the gifts, many the works, one in the Lord of all. One bread, one body, one Lord of all. One cup of blessing which we bless. for the fields, scattered and grown, gather to one, for all. One bread, one body, one Lord of all, one cup of blessing which we bless, and we, though many, throughout the earth, we are one body in this one. Bread for the world, a world of hunger. Wine for all people, people who thirst. May we who eat be bread for others. May we who drink pour out our love.
Let us pray. Pour on us, O Lord, the spirit of your love, and in your kindness, make those you have nourished by this one heavenly bread, one in mind and heart, through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Go in the peace of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Let us pray for the help of St. Michael the Archangel. St. Michael the Archangel, defend us in battle. Be our protection against the wickedness and snares of the devil. May God rebuke him, we humbly pray. And do thou, O Prince of the Heavenly Host, by the power of God, thrust into hell Satan and all the other evil spirits who prowl about the world seeking the ruins of souls. Amen. Amen. A very good evening to everybody.
Thank you, Father.
I sing the mighty power of God that made the mountains rise, that spread the flowing sea abroad, that built the lofty skies. I sing the wisdom of ordained the sun to rule the day. The moon shines full at his command, and all the stars obey. I sing the goodness of the Lord that filled the earth with fruit. He formed the creatures with his word, and then pronounce them good. Lord, how thy wonders of this plain, where'er I turn my eye. If I survey the ground I tread, or gazed upon the sky.